Well, shot broke center mass. This is the second shot with this rifle at 250 yards. Target's down there by the pond. Pulled the first shot about 2 inches to the right, and it hit dead on with the adjustment for the wind. We got about a 5 to 8 mile an hour gust down there in the bottom of the valley. So two clicks seems to compensate at 250 yards. I just corrected the elevation because we hit about 2 inches low. It's supposed to be 0.6 inches high with this Hornady ammunition at 100 and then zeroing out at 200. I didn't adjust any elevation and I didn't know how far away I was while making the shot. I estimated it to be around 200, 220, and I paced it out and it's actually at right at 250 meters or yards. So we're going to close the scope down and head down and check out the impact with the elevation change. No change to the windage from the last shot. See what's going on. So bear with me. Another thing to comment is this is this rifle's round number 8 and 9 fired today during the barrel break-in. I've been shooting one round every 15 to 20 minutes, then running the bore snake through, letting the barrel cool completely down. The first day there was just 4 rounds fired over the course of about 2.5 hours while, you know, making adjustments to the scope and not just, you know, elevation and windage. I had to adjust my eye relief. I adjust the cheek weld on the stock. I had the extra high comb there, brought that down. No adjustment to the length of pull on this 110 Predator. New Athlon scope. Guy at the store had, I guess, good things to say about it. Said it's going to become the new Vortex, you know, the new up-and-comer. So for $399, figured I'd try it out. And this rifle is going to be a, you know, light range, light to medium range, coyote, predator, varmint. And because being a 204 Ruger, it's, you know, something that my kids can shoot without getting scope bit. Ammo's fairly inexpensive so far, but sometimes tough to find in stores. It's, you can find it online, but overall it's not that bad of a headache. We get down here and check out where the splash was. Wind's calming down. You can still see, you know, some of the medium-sized trees swaying. But as the bullet comes off the hill back over there, it's being affected by the wind. Then it gets down here, the wind changes. There's a possible swirl. So just trying to watch some of the grass down here, which is fairly easy to see because there's really, humidity seems kind of low today. There's not a lot of mirage. Looks like tire tracks going off up in that hill. I don't know who would be driving back in here this time of year. Nobody turkey hunts this. All right. Point of aim. This dark splotch right here. Crosshairs broke, center mass at the time of the shot, impact was here. I think the wind may have died down in my two clicks to the left to allow the wind to push the bullet back into the point of aim. I think maybe the wind died down after the shot was released and drifted over roughly. This isn't scientific, this is beer math, as they call it. 2.5, maybe 2 3/4 inches. I don't really really have much of comparison. Well, I got a pocket knife. We can try that. So center of that mark to center of bullet hole is almost right on. Edge of knife to edge of knife, center mass. Elevation, maybe, you know, in reality, maybe a half inch to 5/8 inch drop off of that. So the elevation being adjusted up two clicks, or on the turret says, you know, one click is 1/10 of a mil, so 2/10 of a mil adjustment for the elevation to cover that 200 to 250 meter range or yard range. I'm still stuck in the military meter thing when it comes to distance shooting, but yeah, the different yardage. I mean, but in a, even in the sense of, you know, a squirrel, you know, a half inch, 3/4 inch drop really ain't nothing for that 204. And our shooting site is right up there on that hill. See it kind of coming down right there. But that's where the our hide is today. And that was, this thing has been shot at multiple times over the years with various rifles. That right there is from my 4570. Big O HSM bear lead. But not bad. With the wind dying, I could have left the windage turret at zero and probably would have landed about right there, right below that thing, which, you know, I don't care who you are, that's a dead coyote. That's a dead prairie dog. Whatever you're, that's a dead paper target. So that was 5.